It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Crangle family. Jim, Hal, Pat, Karen, and Jim, ready for action. And the Freeman family. Betty, John, Trish, Norm, and Diane, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Got a nice family. They came from San Francisco, and they became the champs. They're right over here. Frank. Hi, Jim.
Hello, Richard.
Nice to see you, sir.
Nice to see you.
How much did you win the last time? Do you recall?
$1,299.
You do recall. Right? Let's meet everybody, sir.
All right. Our son, Harold.
Hi, Richard.
Nice to see you, Hal.
His wife, Pat.
Hi, Richard.
And I'll give you the next girl's name tonight. Karen.
Karen, that's right.
Hi, Richard.
Nice to see you.
And our oldest son, Jim.
Hi, Jim, Richard. Welcome. Nice to have you here. Didn't you tell me you were an accountant?
That's right.
That's how you remembered how much money you won.
I counted it.
And you said 40 years, over 40 years you've been doing that?
Yes.
How long have you been married?
Been married, will be 47 years in September.
Really?
Same girl.
That's lovely. Remember how you met your wife? How did you meet her?
We were working in the same place.
Oh, really? What's her name?
Olga.
Olga. I want you to have another good 47 years.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you. There's a nice family here to challenge you. The Freeman Rock.
How are you, buddy?
Fine, Richard, thank you.
I want to meet your family, please.
I'd love you to meet my family. This is my son, my nephew, John.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, John.
And his sister, Trish, and they're from Australia.
Oh. Hello,
visiting
Richard.
Me.
Nice to have you here.
And then there's my daughter, Norma.
Hello, Richard. Norma.
And then at the end, my daughter, Diane.
Welcome. So I hear a little accent with you. Now, where were you born?
Oh, well, I was born also in Australia.
I thought so.
Yes, but I've been here a long time.
You thought John was your son, Virginia.
I wish he was sometimes.
Now, are you visiting us, John? Or do you live here in America?
I'm visiting, Richard.
With Trish?
With my sister.
Yes.
You're visiting?
Yes.
For a reason.
What's the reason, John?
I'm to be married next Sunday at a little town called San Juan.
San Juan Capistrano.
That's correct.
Is this Sunday coming?
This Sunday coming.
Who's the lucky lady? What's her name?
Lynn.
Is she here?
She's in the audience. Richard.
Is she an American young lady?
She is. She's a Californian.
What excellent taste. Where is our pride to be?
Go on, kid.
Lynn. Oh, she's gorgeous. She's beautiful. Yes. Let's hope you win a lot of money.
Thanks, Richard.
Come on, we're going to play the feud. Let's go. Each other. 100 people surveyed. Top 7 answers are on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something about which most fathers lecture their teenage sons.
Becoming a man.
Becoming a man. No. Jim?
Drugs.
Drugs. There, what are you going to do? Play or pass?
We'll play.
They're going to play. I'm going to find out if you did lecture them. How you doing?
How you doing, Richard?
Nice to see you. Something about which most fathers lecture their teenage sons.
My dad spent a lot of time lecturing to me about sex.
Did he?
Yeah.
Like the birds and the bees.
With magazines.
A sex. Hello, Angel. Can you think? He's going to lose all his accounts, you know. What do you think fathers lecture their teenage sons about?
The importance of a college education.
All right, good answer. Good answer.
An education. Not as much fun as the magazines, but certainly a good answer. What do you think dads are going to lecture their teenage sons about, Karen?
About the importance of their career.
All right, very good answer. Right.
Very important for your career.
Oh.
All right.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Richard.
Nice to see you, Jim. What would you say, sir?
Respect your elders.
Okay. Right. Always respect your elders. Well, there's some unemployed bum who's rude to elderly people floating around somewhere, from what I can gather. Jim, you can save your reputation here now. Give me an answer.
Honesty.
I like your style. If it's there, okay. If not, there's drag. Honesty. No. $33, Betty. Tie your kangaroos down and get over to the podium.
What do you want to do?
I need... Darling, I need an answer for the buzzer.
How to drive safely.
All righty, fine.
Sorry.
If it's all right, it's your first time.
Yeah.
But when they buzz, I have to call for
yeah,
an answer.
Yeah, I know. I understand.
Driving there, you get $33. If not, Jim and the magazines will get it. Drive! Three.
Sleeping.
Five.
Money.
Six.
Smoking cigarettes.
My dad said never ever go to a strip joint. I found out why later. That's where he was going. We'll be back right after this. Come on, Hal, let's go. And 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an expense you have only once a year.
Yeah. Telephone.
The telephone. Maybe in Australia they bill you once a year. I don't know. What do you say?
Christmas presents.
Christmas presents?
Yeah.
You got it.
We're going to play.
We're going to
play.
We're
going to play.
We're going to play, Jen. I don't know. I'm going to ask, do you get billed monthly for your telephone?
Quarterly, Richard.
Quarterly. Well, see, every 3 months. Here, they don't trust you that long. Because
no.
Otherwise, we'd run up to a lot of bills. I'd have called Lynn up in San Juan to help us. An expense you have only once a year.
How about a birthday?
All right, let's look.
Yeah, a birthday.
Right.
Okay.
Not bad. All right. I thought it was... a reasonable answer? What would you say?
Income tax.
Yes! Good answer!
Income tax.
Oh, hey! Yeah!
What would you say?
College tuition.
Ready?
Yes, yes.
College tuition. Second strike. Jim. Man of figures, this will probably be all right for you. An expense you have only once a year.
I'll try Thanksgiving expenses.
Yeah?
All right.
You didn't do Nixon's taxes, did you? Thanksgiving's there, okay. If not, third strike. Thanksgiving! No. Well, I come to the quarterly telephone people. Chance for you to make a comeback right here. An expense you have only once a year.
Car registration.
Were you going to say car registration, Richard?
All righty, then. Car registration is there. You get the $80. If not, Jim gets it. Car registration. Four. All right. Oh, boy, the boomerang people are doing well. We'll be back right after that.
sorry about that. No, no, I've been...
Well, let's go. How are you? Well, we're glad you're here visiting.
Thank you very much.
You make our whole world nicer just to look at you.
You're lovely.
Oh, isn't she, sweetheart?
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. First family to get the 300, please, for $5,000. 100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name somebody whose picture appears on money. Yeah.
A president.
Good answer.
Good answer.
A president. Well, they want you to name somebody, though.
Lincoln.
Lincoln.
We'll play.
Very proud of you,
okay.
Doc.
Thank you.
Okay. Somebody whose picture appears on money.
Well, I'd have to say our first president, right? Benjamin. Whoa! George Washington, I'm sorry.
Yeah, Benjamin, whoa, I don't think. He got defeated in the primaries, didn't he? He was doing well. George? Who are we going to see on your money?
I'd say Alexander Hamilton.
Yes, look, Alexander Hamilton. Well?
I'm going to say Benjamin Franklin.
Oh, Benjamin Woo Franklin. Uncle Ben? Well, yes, you've been here a couple of times, so you obviously have used our currency.
Richard, I'll say John F. Kennedy.
Okay, very good.
Good
answer. JFK. No, but he's there, all right. I mean, hey, that's a good answer.
Well, how about Roosevelt?
Okay. All right, we'll take a look. Gene Stapleton. Roosevelt, FDR? Not that. Well?
How about Thomas Jefferson?
Okay. If Tom's there, all right. If not, we're shot. Thomas Jefferson? Yeah! Very good recovery. Going to polish this off? Mm-hmm. What do you say?
Andrew Jackson.
$96. Come on, champs. You can get the money and get in the game.
Grant.
Going with Grant.
Cary Grant?
Yeah.
Earl Grant?
Yes.
What Grant do you mean?
Ulysses S.
I like your style. And if he's there, you get the $96. They've done a big lead. The Grant? You got it. 1-13-96, let's go! Come on! Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed, top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something that is made for just two people. Yeah.
Dinner.
Three seconds, come on. Something that's made for just two people.
A double bed. We're
going to
play, Richard.
Good. You know who invented the double bed?
No, I don't.
Benjamin, whoa! Kept falling out of the single bed, if I recall. What's made for just two people?
A two-seated sports car.
Okay. Yep. Just a seat there.
Way
under. Oh, Diane, okay. Yeah. A two-seated sports car. Betty?
A service for two. China service for two.
Okay.
Good on you.
It's a regular service for eight that you split it up and give to four people. They never, as long as they don't know each other, they never meet. A service for two.
Well, Richard, as I'm getting married, I'll have to say a wedding cake.
Okay, if it's there, all right, and if not, second strike, a wedding cake. This has got to be the cheapest wedding they've had in a long time. Well, my lovely.
Okay, a tandem bicycle.
Shame on you, shame, because you all know that song. Crazy, right? A bicycle made for two. Tandem. You know, it's just made for two people.
Well, since I've got the wedding on my mind, because Lynn was my roommate, that's how John met her, I have to say wedding rings.
Wedding rings, all right, my love. That's there, okay, if not Thursday. Wedding ring? No. $84 up here? Whatever you say.
Love seat.
What's your answer, Jim?
Love seat.
If it's there, you get the 84. If not, better you do. A love seat? Let's go. Come on. This is going to decide it. I wish you both luck. Now, dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here is the question. Name a specific pest people call an exterminator to get rid of.
Yeah. Roaches.
Roaches. You got it? What are you going to do? Well done.
Okay.
Listen carefully. I'm not going to repeat the question. When I get to you, you've got 3 seconds to answer it. Name a specific pest people call an exterminator to get rid of.
Termites.
Termites.
Right, good answer.
Termite.
All right. All right. Yeah. Rats.
Yeah. Rats.
Yeah. How about fleas?
Looking for fleas. Well, not really looking for them, but fleas.
Ants.
Oh, Karen and the ants.
All right.
All right.
Mice.
Yes.
Mice, there you keep your title. If not, get ready. Woo. Mice.
Yes.
Dear, oh, this means we won't get invited to the wedding.
No.
Well, the cake is only for two anyway. Heck of a drive. We got $113. I'm also going to add $100. That's for you and your lady to buy a bottle of champagne and to toast each other on your wedding night with that $100.
Thank you very much, Richard.
And we want you to be happy. I'm sorry you didn't win more, but I'm glad we met you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Richard.
Thank you. Name an appliance you might have more than one of in your home.
Toaster.
The hour when parties get lively.
11 o'clock.
A flavor of Jell-O.
Strawberry.
Common color for hats.
Brown.
A sport with a specific season.
Football.
Turn around, Jim. An appliance you might have more than one of in your home. You're obviously up to your hips in toasters. Survey said. 6. The hour when parties get lively. 11. Survey said. Flavor is yellow. Strawberry. Survey. Common color of a hat. Brown. Survey said. Sport for the specific season. Football. Survey. I like that. Karen, Karen, Karen. All you need is 31 points, and you have the $5,000. Please remind everyone the great answers Jim gave us. 20 seconds on the clock. Here we go. Name an appliance you might have more than one of in your home.
Spoon.
Excuse me. Here we go. The hour when parties get lively.
11.
Try again.
12.
Flavor of Jell-O.
Strawberry.
Try again.
Lime.
A common color for hats.
Brown.
Try again.
Black.
A sport with a specific season.
Football.
Try again.
Baseball.
Turn around. appliance you might have more than one of in your home, a spoon.
I am too spoon.
My appliance, by the way, is broken, and if you can find a store where they fix them, because I've got about, I got about eight at home. Sir, they said? Yeah, very unusual number one answer. Television. The hour when party get lively. 10 p.m. was number one. You said midnight, survey said. 20. Flavor of Jell-O. Strawberry was number one. You said lime. You need 11 points for the money. Survey said. 8. Common color for hats. Brown was number one. You said black. 3 points, $5,000. Remember, you're with child. Don't jump.
No,
survey
I'm not.
Said.
Parting contestants receive pure sous vide honey. No synthetic or artificial ingredients. You haven't tried honey till you've tried the natural goodness of sous vide honey. Dixie Livingware helps you do more for the people you care for with some of the prettiest plates, bowls, and cups you'll never wash. From Blue Luster Home Care Products, Blue Luster Dry, the new upholstery cleaner for velvets and other delicate furniture fibers. Try Trident Sugarless Gum, the great tasting sugarless gum with 5 flavors, including bubblegum. Trident, for families who care about their teeth. This is Gene.